Hello everyone, this is Preeti Mule, Associate Professor, Modern Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Indore. Today, we'll be studying the topic Pilot Plant Design for Tablets from the subject Industrial Pharmacy. The primary responsibility of the pilot plant staff is to ensure that the newly formulated tablets developed by product development personnel will prove to be efficiently, economically, and consistently reproducible on a production scale. The design and construction of the pharmaceutical pilot plant for tablet development should incorporate features necessary to facilitate maintenance and cleanliness. If possible, it should be located on the ground floor to expedite the delivery and shipment of supplies. The extraneous and microbiological contamination must be guarded against by incorporating the following features in the pilot plant design. The fluorescent lighting fixtures should be the ceiling flush type. The various operating areas should have floor drains to simplify cleaning. The area should be air conditioned and humidity controlled. High density concrete floors should be installed. The walls in the processing and packaging areas should be enamel cement co-finish on concrete. The equipment in the pharmaceutical pilot plant should be similar to that used by production division for the manufacture of tablets. This is the layout for the pilot plant for tablets. Coming to the various considerations for the pilot plant production of tablets, firstly, it is the first part that is considered is the material handling system. This is the image of the vacuum loading machine. Second comes the dry blending. The powders should be used for encapsulation or to be granulated prior to tableting must be well blended to ensure good drug distribution. Inadequate blending could result in drug content uniformity variation, especially when the tablet or capsule is small or the drug concentration is relatively low. The ingredients should be lumps free, otherwise it can cause flow problems. Granulations. The reasons for granulations are, firstly, it improves the flow properties. Second, to increase the apparent density of the powder, and finally to change the particle size distribution so that the binding properties or compaction can be improved. Three types of granulations are available, namely the wet granulation, the dry granulation, as well as the direct compression method. A small amount of potent active ingredient can be dispersed most effectively in a carrier granulation when the drug is dissolved in the granulating solution.